The Oscar nominations were just released. Okay, Joker led with 11 nominations, with The Irishman not far behind. Among the others nominated are Little Women, Marriage Story, 1917, and Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Best Actor nominees include Leo, of course, Adam Driver, Joaquin Phoenix. Among the ladies up for Best Actress are Charlize Theron, Renee Zellweger, and ScarJo. Now, ScarJo was also nominated, forget this, Best Supporting Actress, along with Margot Robbie and Laura Dern. Brad Pitt and Tom Hanks both got Best Supporting Actor nods, but check out the nominees for Best Director. Notice anything? They're all men.
Oh.
And it wasn't just us that noticed. Take a look.
Congratulations to those men. And finally.
So that was Issa Rae just giving it to us straight, being like, yeah, congratulations to those men. If you didn't know, Greta Gerwig's Little Woman is supposedly be perfectly directed, and a huge miss there. J-Lo was also not nominated for Hustlers. Robert De Niro missed out for The Irishman. Adam Sandler was passed over for Uncut Gems. And Golden Globe winner Awkwafina did not even hear her name called this morning either. What do you think of the nominees? I'm not going to go there and be like, hashtag Oscars so white, but you have a very white group of people, and I have to call that out. What do you guys think?
Well, I want to celebrate Cynthia Erivo, who just became the 11th black actress nominated for an Oscar right here
for Harriet Tubman.
Right. And if she wins, she becomes the youngest person to ever win an EGOT. I love that.
Wow.
I also want to throw out a shout out to, because you know, hashtag more than an athlete, got to shout out my athlete, Matthew A. Cherry, who has this animated series called Hair Love that's up. And one of my former CFL football players, teammates, he executive produced it, Andrew Hawkins. So congratulations, guys. Hope you guys win. Hashtag more than an athlete.
That's awesome. Right. What do you guys think? Anything about the whiteness of everything?
Well, Issa Rae hat is just always a mood. So whatever. But I think that J-Lo got snubbed because I don't think that Hustlers was the best movie ever, but I do think that her performance was phenomenal in that movie. It was way too long. I didn't love it, but she acted the heck out of that role.
I can't believe, honestly, that Awkwafina winning the Golden Globes was not even nominated.
Is that unprecedented?
I can't imagine many of that has ever happened. So
and
big snub.
Someone else said that if there was more people in the pool and that more female directors got opportunities, then we would have a better playing field, even if the guys did have the best movies this year.
I think that's total BS, but yeah, I'll go with that.